The Choctawhatchee High School cheerleaders have won 4 FHS AA state championships, 3 in the 1A small co-ed division and 1 in the medium varsity division. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here they are, the Choctawhatchee Indianettes. Your attention to the 50-yard line on the home side. At this time, we would like to make a special presentation. Tonight, Choctawhatchee High School is proud to induct 5 individuals into the school's Hall of Fame. The Choctaw Hall of Fame was established in 2012 as part of the school's 60th anniversary celebration. These 5 individuals to be inducted tonight have distinguished themselves in service to our school and community and were chosen by a committee for induction. Joining us tonight for the ceremony are members of the Hall of Fame inducted in previous years. How about a big green welcome for Miss Elaine Anderson, Mr. Richard Bounds, Mrs. Jimmy Hamilton, Mr. Fred Pitts, Mr. Eddie Taylor, Miss Sherilyn Neighbors Darnell, Mr. Todd Gatlin, Miss Mary Pitts, representing her father, Mr. Richard Pitts, Mrs. Carolyn Briganti, representing her husband, Mr. Jerry Briganti, and Mr. Billy Michael. And now we would like to introduce this year's inductees. Our first inductee is Mr. Richard Covey. Mr. Covey is a 1964 Choctaw graduate where he was class president. He attended the U.S. Air Force Academy, receiving a Bachelor of Science degree in Astronautical Engineering. He also holds a Master's degree from Purdue University in Aeronautics and Astronautics. A former astronaut, Covey commanded 4 shuttle flights, including the flight of Endeavour, to service and repair the Hubble telescope. He has received numerous accolades, including being inducted into the Astronaut Hall of Fame, 5 Air Force Distinguished Flying Crosses, and 16 Air Medals. He is retired as President and Chief Executive Officer of the United Space Alliance and currently serves on the Board of Directors, REMAX, and the Astronaut Scholarship Foundation. He and his wife, Kathleen, have 2 daughters and 3 granddaughters. Senior Class President Stephen Foster will present Mr. Covey with his Hall of Fame medal. Our next inductee is Lionel Fayard. Lionel Fayard is a former coach and athletic director at Choctaw. He was head football coach from 1985 through 1997. The 1990 football team he coached won the Class 5A state championship and the first state championship in any sport at the school. That team finished 12-2, and 11 players signed with Division I schools, including Penn State, Vanderbilt, the Air Force Academy, and the Naval Academy. Tonight, he is celebrating the 25th anniversary of that championship with many of those players. Coach Fayard was a standout athlete at Biloxi High School, winning All-State honors. He attended the University of Southern Mississippi, where he holds several records and is in the Alumni Hall of Fame. Coach Fayard is married to Patty Fayard, and they have three grown children. He is retired from the Okaloosa County School District. Darby Jens, junior class president, will present Mr. Fayard with his Hall of Fame medal. Our next inductee is Ms. Nancy Crinkle. Nancy Crinkle is a former member of the Choctaw faculty. Under her inspiration and guidance, she brought together the stakeholders to start the first international baccalaureate program at the school. 17 classes of students, more than 500 students have received an IB diploma. The program is the only one of its kind in Okaloosa County. Ms. Crinkle is active with several nonprofit organizations in the area. She and her husband Andy have one daughter, Taylor, who is an officer in the United States Air Force. Sophomore class president Bailey Pettit will present Ms. Crinkle with her Hall of Fame medal. Our next inductee is Roy Pike. Roy Pike is a member of the first graduating class of Choctawhatchee High School. He and his classmates were instrumental in starting the many traditions for which our school is known. Mr. Pike was a starter on the football team. In fact, he kicked off the very first football to start off the Choctaw football program. He was also an outstanding runner. His teammates nicknamed him Running Deer because no one could catch him. After high school, Mr. Pike served his country in the United States Air Force. After retiring, he started his own business, Florida Postcard Producers. He still works part-time. He is joined tonight by his six children and their families. Freshman class president Johnny Holby will present Mr. Pike with his Hall of Fame medal. And our final inductee tonight is Mrs. Marcy Clemens Spivey. Marcy Clemens Spivey was valedictorian of the class of 1993 and a champion golfer. She received a full golf scholarship to Auburn University, where she was named SEC Player of the Year in 1996. Ms. Spivey was a two-time All-American and was on the academic All-SEC and All-American honor rolls each year. She played on the Futures Tour in 1997. In 2012, she was inducted into the Auburn University Athletic Hall of Fame. She graduated summa cum laude with a Master of Accountancy from Auburn University in 1998 and is currently a Senior Vice President and Senior Tax Consultant for the Southeast Region of Bessemer Trust, a multi-family office and wealth management firm. She and her two daughters live in Atlanta, where she continues to play golf. ICC Co-Chairman C.J. McDonald will present Ms. Spivey with her Hall of Fame medal. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our induction ceremony. Please give a round of applause for all the members of the Choctawhatchee High School Hall of Fame.
And welcome back to a happy Joe Etheredge Stadium. Five very deserving individuals just being inducted into the Choctaw Hall of Fame, the last of which, Marcy Clemens Spivey, an outstanding All-SEC, All-American golfer in the Auburn Walk of Fame and Hall of Fame as well. Coach Lionel Fayard, and that's where little Lionel is making his way back up from down there with his pop, watching his pop being inducted. Again, the Indians 2-2 tonight. Hosting the Arnold Marlins at 1-3. The Marlins are coached by Josh Wright. They're ranked 261st in the state, 4,061st nationally in the Max Preps Power Rankings. They have had, one win against Fort Walton Beach, 41-21. They lost to Florida High, 29-22. Lost to Walton, 28-8. And last week, their first district game against the Bay Tornadoes, they losing 24-22. Conversely, the Indians ranked 2-2. No district games as of yet. We crank that up next week. Coach Greg Thomas in his eighth season, 53-10, won 89-81 in his 23 years as a head coach. The Indians are ranked 87th in the state, 980th nationally in the Max Preps Power Rankings. We're going to pause here for our national anthem, played by the Choctawhatchee Style Marchers, I believe.
Thank you. And now remain standing as the Choctawhatchee Air Force Junior ROTC proudly presents our nation's colors. Commanding and carrying the flag of the United States of America is Cadet First Sergeant Bryce Hood. Carrying the Florida State flag is Cadet Lieutenant Colonel James Wellaha. With rifles tonight, Cadet Chief Master Sergeant Anthony Jett and Cadet Chief Master Sergeant Tepalonsi.
The colors are now being presented. And soon to follow, our nation's national anthem on a very heartbreaking week here in Okaloosa County with the events that have happened.
Tonight we will say the Pledge of Allegiance, which will be immediately followed by the playing of our national anthem.
First will be the Pledge of Allegiance, if you can catch that from Public Address National Leader Lee Hale.
President Bailey Pettit, as she says, our Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now remain standing as the Style Marchers play our national anthem.
Great night here at the stadium. We're going to take 10 seconds for station identification. Hall of Fame night here at Joe Etheredge Stadium. How's our newest Hall of Famer down there? Is he going to be able to fit in the doorway in your house in Kenwood?
Oh, yeah.
A humble man.
He's happy and excited, and that's a nice honor that he received, and I think he attributes it to all the young men he was able to coach, and it goes out to them as well.
The last time we played the Arnold Marlins about 3 or 4 years ago, and they had a running back, a D1 running back, went to Southern Miss. This year it's a quarterback named Cody Saunders.
Yeah, Cody's completed 85 out of 124 attempts for just under 1,000 yards, 973, 4 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. He also is the leading rusher, averaging 6.9 yards attempt. He's had 6 touchdowns, goes for about 94 yards a game, so he's going to run it and going to throw it. And the receiver that he likes to throw to, Juwan White, 18 catches, 230 yards. He also likes Trevor Kilcrease, 16 receptions, 210 yards. So they'll spread it out. Jamani Barnes, the next leading rusher, 23 attempts, 127 yards, 2 touchdowns. So they're pretty much a 1-2 punch with these guys.
Right, and Saunders, watching some of that Fort Walton game highlights, he'll put 4 or 5 out in the route, and if they're not there, he'll tuck it and run. And he is very fleet of foot. The Indians looking to find some identity both offensively and defensively up front. Coach Thomas telling me that off the air, saying we just got to get tougher, mentally tougher and physically tougher up front. And, you know, when your leading rusher is your quarterback and it's because he's running for his life, that's not a good thing.
Yeah, and that's one of those things where they're having to replace starters and kids are having to learn the high school game. They haven't had a lot of starts, but over time they will. Coach, he's got a great staff, and they'll get better each game, and he puts them in positions where they can be successful.
Kind of like we said in the Coach Moore days back when Jack Allen was playing, when your strong safety is your leading tackler, something's not good. And the leading tackler for the Indians right now by one tackle is Chris Pickett. The Indians have won the toss and will elect to receive. Zach Nash, Pennington, Washington, Smirsky, Klein, and DeAndre Hooks up front with Dorsey alternating in at tight end as well. Jake Fairley, your quarterback, 6'2", buck 85, transfer from Fort Walton Beach High School, and he's been well received. Marquise Kane, 5'8", 175, junior. Mike Turner, the fullback. Vidal Morrell, wide receiver. Richie Grant will play some. The Smith brothers, I learned something new this week. The brothers Smith, Daniel Smith and Isaac Smith, both brothers at wide receiver. We won't see David Sherman tonight. Apparently he got hurt on that high snap on the punt, so it'll be Jake Fairley doing the punting. And our good friend Mendoza doing the kickoff duties. Indians with a different look tonight, green jerseys.
Go with the black pants and green jerseys and the black helmets, looking good. And Tom, looking closer at the Arnold Marlins, you know, they have played a fairly tough schedule. Florida High, they're traditionally pretty stout. They came up a touchdown short over there, 29-22. They beat Fort Walton Beach, and they played a tough Walton squad. You know, they're talented and athletic. They got behind early and couldn't come back. And Bay is the talented school in Panama City this year. They only lost by 2, 24-22. So the Indians will have to play their every game, and if they come around and have some fumbles or some miscues, it could be a long evening. So we'll have to see how that plays out tonight for the big Indians.
The Marlins averaging 23 a game. They're giving up 26. Conversely, on the other side of the coin, the Indians averaging 40 points a game, but giving up 37. I believe that's a misnomer. That math's a little off. I don't think I divided by four. We'll work on that one during a break. That's that new math they talk about. And added bonus tonight, we're going to be streaming this game live on Emerald Coast TV. RJ Murdoch and his crew out simulcasting this, and I'm sure it's next week sometime it'll be on Channel 6. I'm hearing that a lot. So
exciting for the Indian faithful and fans, especially for the young men, able to catch it later on the internet.
I would say deep to receive, but not really. Hanging around their own 10-yard line are Chris Pickett and Richie Grant, teeing it up on the right hash mark to do the honors. It's number 13, Nick Guzman. Guzman looks like he'll take a couple-step approach and maybe go to school on what some other teams have done and skykick this thing. About ready to go here at Joe Etheridge Stadium. Game number 5, the midway point. Toe meets leather. It's a short kick right in the middle of the field. Do we get it? We do, at the 25-yard line. Kalen Lovitz across the 30s, across the 40, down at the 42.
Kalen did a good job. They kicked it over to the far hash mark. He folded it in behind his wall, looked for an opening, and cut it up to the 45.
Jake Fairley trots out, the senior. The family Fairley. Watched the volleyball game last night. Heartbreaking for the Indians' loss to Fort Walton. But his sister Cassandra Fairley excelling there. His sister Samantha Fairley helping here with the stats. He's already graduated. And I understand we got an 8th grade girl at Saul World.
Yeah, they're a talented bunch.
Hand off right side, Marquise Kane. Circle spins for a couple yards up across the 44 to the 45.
Michael Turner back in there. Missed him last week at fullback, 6 foot, 220-pound junior, leading the way for Marquise in the I, traditional I formation.
Indians going a little hurry up. Split twins left, toss sweep left side. Kane, he bobbles it. It catches it in the air, and he's going to go down for about a 6-yard loss, or 4-yard loss, back to the 38. That play blew up from the start. I'm just a hair concerned about the left side of this O-line for the Indians. Looked like they're lined up offsides 2 plays in a row and got away with it.
It looked like the tight end was hugging the line.
Oh, we got twins, right twins, left third down, fairly out of the gun. Fairly with a three-step drop. He's got single coverage right and throws this one over toward the Arnold bench.
We had an in route. Chris Pickett was running 10 yards, coming straight across the yard line there and threw the up route.
So Indians three and out to open the game. Fairley will stay in, and he'll punt it. Hunter Merrill will snap it.
Into punt for the Indians, number 12, Jake Fairley.
Fairley is 13 yards deep at his own 27. Good snap. Low end-over-end kick away from everybody. Kind of went hard left. A duck hook out of bounds at the 30. They're going to have spotted it now at the 41-yard line, 42-yard line. Net punt of about 12 yards.
He boomed a couple against Rickards. And then he just missed that one just a little bit.
Just a hair. So Cody Saunders will bring the Marlins. They'll be swimming downstream toward the south end zone, toward Racetrack Road. Saunders, good-looking kid, 6'2", 202. They've got him listed as a DB as well. Getting the play from the sideline. There's still plenty of time on the play clock. They've got trips left. They'll line up in the old lunch line left formation. Twins right, so going empty first play out of the spread. From the 41, Saunders just keeps it and runs it himself. It's about three. Here will Tallahassee Rickards play.
They just spread everybody out. That takes five men out of the box and gives them good numbers to run the football. That's exactly what they tried to do.
Rickards did that expertly, especially on the two-point conversions. Make it a little five-on-five game. Or six-on-six. Second down, six to go. From the Indian 46. Just underway here at Joe Etheridge Stadium. No score. Indians three and out on the first possession. Saunders, high snap. He'll run the read option. Keeps it himself and go down with a loss of about a yard.
Should have pulled it sooner or just went ahead and handed it off. He let the defense pursue to him. Took the effectiveness of that play away. Good job, Indian defense.
Sanders averaging 7 yards a carry. Not on that one, so it's going to bring up third down. They'll lose a half a yard on the play. Third down, call it seven. Trips right, single receiver left. Saunders going out of the spread the whole way so far. Saunders looking to pass over the middle. Got his man, complete for a first down to the Indian 44-yard line. Complete to number 20, Juwan White.
Juwan White, just a good route. Hooked it up in front of Chris Pickett. Nice throw. Pitch and catch there for the Arnold Marlins.
White averaging 12 yards a catch, right at his average. Chains will move for the Marlins. First and 10 from the Indian 44. Coach Thomas talked last week about getting off the field on third down, how important it was. Wide, they're going to toss, sweep it left, get some blocking out front, and no gain on the play.
Chris Pickett on the tackle, strong safety, filled the alley inside out like you're supposed to. Good sound defensive play by Chris Pickett.
Play goes for no gain. Second down, 10 yards to go.
Second and 10. Saunders will send trips right. Single back with him is Thompson. Jaquan Thompson. As in most teams today, the Marlins going no huddle. Not real hurry up by any means. High snap, brought down. Saunders will keep it himself, and he's got about seven. Across the 40, down to about the 37-yard line.
I think Saunders is a big kid, 6'2", 215, so he's like a tailback running it.
4 minutes gone here in the opening quarter, no score. Joe Etheridge Stadium here on Hall of Fame night. Third and three. Saunders sends trips right out of the spread. Now they'll look to the sideline. Plenty of time on the play clock.
You need to change defense on them.
Saunders now looks at his wristband. There's five on the clock. Looking right to throw. Incomplete.
Good job by Betts. Broke on the hitch route intended for Paul Patterson. But Betts hit the ball right as it hit his hands, jarred it loose. Great job by Miles Betts.
Going to be fourth and four for the Marlins. I watched them in pregame as they were practicing a punting from right about this distance, practicing pooch punting. We'll see if they, normally it would be go time for the Indians. Trevor Kilcrease will be in the punt, a 6'1", 175 senior. Off the side of his foot, but that's not too bad. It's going to take a Indian bounce sideways, now bounces forward, and the Marlins will down it at the 19-yard line. So the Marlins wanting to give the Indians a long field to work with.
Good job by the Indians getting off the field on third down. Miles Betts with the pass breakup and get the offense another chance.
From the 19, no score here. 7:16 to play, opening quarter. Again, simulcasting on Emerald Coast TV, ECITV.com. Indians operating out of the eye. There's Kane. Marquise Kane at the 30. He's at the 40. Kane, 30, 20, 10.
Get there.
Take it down at about the 2.
What a play. He goes 80 yards, doesn't get in the end zone, but he goes about 77 yards. Great job. Big hole for him to run through there. He showed his great burst. Give him a break.
Kind of like DeMarco Murray, more comfortable out of the eye. Kane just took that one and saw the field, saw his hole, and took it.
He has times where he has great burst. He showed it there.
Spotted at the 4. Now a power eye formation. First time we've seen this year. Kane, right side, gets it after he's winded. Fights his way down near the goal line. Touchdown, Indians. 3-yard touchdown run by Marquise Kane. That drive was all Marquise Kane. 6-0 Indians. Now the all-important extra point.
Can we kick one?
It's the old tripod, three legs, and you got a snap, a hold, and a kick. Mendoza will kick it. Richie Graham will hold it. Hunter Merrill will snap it. Good snap. Kick is up. It's good. The Indians are 1-for-1 on extra points and have 7 points on the board. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on Emerald Coast TV. Indians go 3-and-out on the first possession, stop the Marlins, and then score to make it 7-0 with just under 7 minutes to play. This touchdown summary brought to you by Emerald Coast Funeral Home.
This will be a quick one. 25 seconds off the game clock. Two big runs by Marquise Kane. On first down, he goes 78 yards down to the 3. Second down, gets a big block. The offensive lineman, the big sophomore, Jason Godfrey, 6'2", 275, checks in at fullback. He followed him into the end zone, capping off the 81-yard drive in two plays.
All Marquise Kane all on the ground. Toting the rock, Mendoza will kick it. His first kickoff of the night from the right hash. Short kick taken at the 4. 10. Going backwards, and down he goes. Not yet.
Ball's out.
The Indians have it. We say we do. Let's see if there's the call. Do we get it? We do. Indians have it at the 17-yard line.
I think John Bernay fell on it. Miles Betts gives the ball to the official, but 18 came flying down. John Bernay, a French. Off a little bit, but great job on the fumble recovery, and I wish I could see who popped it and dropped, made him fumble.
No matter what, we have it at the 16 on the right hash mark. If you're listening on the radio, if you're watching it on TV, you see it. Eye formation once again for the Indians. Kane's your eye back. Twins left. Play action. Three steps. Looking complete out in the flat. Isaac Smith has it at about the 12.
He bobbled it, but was able to recapture it before he got hit.
Isaac, the junior, his brother, Daniel Smith, the senior.
yards. Second down, 7 yards to go.
Second and seven. Indians from the 12. We lead it 7-0. Option play. Fairley keeps it. No, hands it off inside to Turner. Fairley faked me out. Turner gets a couple.
Coming Wildcat action. Nope. But Pickett.
Chris Pickett comes in.
And Richie Grant.
Zach Childers checks out.
Third down, 5 yards to go.
We'll send twins right and twins left. Kane's the setback out of the spread. Motion. Richie Grant on the jet sweep. It's a reverse. Back to Pickett. Pickett is at the 10. Pickett knocked out of bounds at the 6. So a little razzle-dazzle from the north end of the field.
We got a holding. We're going to back it up 10 yards from where that flag is. That one hurts. We got replay on the Emerald Coast TV.
We will see. We've got it when we're working at it at the Raider games. I'm not sure if we have it in play right now. That'll back the Indians up.
Unfortunately, Arnold played that one textbook style. They stayed at home with the defensive end, and he got upfield, forcing Alex Smirsky to do something to try to create a lane for Pickett coming across the left side. Holding was the call.
5 minutes, 29 seconds to play. We'll take a short break for hydration. This water break brought to you by Dr. Lynn Keefe and Pediatrics of Okaloosa County. Dr. Lynn Keefe, Dr. Burton, doing great things for the Touchdown Club. Year in and year out, Lynn Keefe being there for a long time. After this, the Marlins go into the meat of their district schedule. They host Mosley and will be at Rutherford, a non-district game, and then have two in a row at Pensacola High and then versus West Florida Tech. They'll close it out with Milton.
Wow.
The Indians, as we've said so many times, it starts the highway from heck starts here. We go to Crestview. You have a week off, then it's at Niceville. Host Tate, Fort Walton Beach at home, and then at Mosley.
That's a tough. Arnold's got a good-looking squad, Tom. I mean, they're not a bad ball club, but they might just win one game this year. They've got athletes across the board. That's a tough schedule.
Fairley swings it out in the flat, complete. Kane dances around, gets down to the 20-yard line, the original line of scrimmage, around the 16.
Good job by Marquise. Good swing pass in the flats. A lot of yards needed to gain, but he got what he could before he had run out of bounds.
So Mendoza will try a field goal from the 25. It'll be the right hash mark, a 35-yard attempt. Just 1 yard short of that make he had in the same angle at Pine Forest.
This will be huge if we can get a good hold, a good snap, and kick this one through.
Hunter snaps it. Richie holds it. Kicks it up. It's a
through.
Low liner. Did it go through? No, low left.
Man.
I don't think that one ever got above 12 feet off the ground.
You know, if we have this game kind of under control, right now 7-0 in the first quarter, 4 minutes and 40 seconds left, we got to practice that more. I mean, we need some more attempts. Unfortunately, if we could have kicked 2 field goals last week when we had to go for it on fourth down, we'd be sitting here with the win against Navarre. Not important, but at some point, if you're going to be a good football team, you have to put points on the board when you kick a field goal.
Out of the spread, twins left, twins right. Waiting to get this one going. Not sure what the delay is. The chain gang on the far side of the field. They're set. Now we're ready to go. Marlins will have it from their own 20. Cody Saunders out of the spread. Quick pass, quick slant, incomplete. White, again, the intended receiver.
White had a catch earlier. Came into the game with only 1 catch for 6 yards. Has 1 for 12 yards tonight.
Second down.
was looking at rushing, sorry.
He's rushed it one time.
Juwan White's their leading receiver.
He'll spread it around. White's had 18, Kilcrease with 16, Patterson with 16 receptions. Second down, same play again, complete to White on a little hitch up around the 28-yard line.
Kind of taking what the Indians are going to give them. They're backed off in a two-deep coverage. They're spreading the field. Can't jam him. He's their leading receiver in the slot. You can't get anybody on him unless you walk him back or out.
Third down and a yard. Saunders will go under center, take quarterback sneak. He's a big guy, like we said, 200 pounds, and I think he's got it.
First down, Marlins.
So the Marlins not doing so bad, racking up first downs. Indians lead at 7-0 early here in the first quarter. Or early here in the ball game. We're under 4 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Trips left. Single receiver to the right. Saunders rides the option. Hands it off inside. Nothing there for Jaquan Thompson.
Colby Dorsey planted him. Good form tackle by Dorsey, the 6 foot 200 pound senior. Got his neck roll on. Good play by the middle linebacker.
Second down. He'll say he lost a yard, so it's 11 to go. Trips left for Saunders here. Hall of Fame night at Joe Etheredge Stadium. Saunders staring down the left and down. He's going to go behind the 25-yard line back at the 23.
Trey Broadwater, 6'1", 200-pound senior defensive end, came charging around the left side. He had no chance, did Sanders.
$50 out of the coffers of Dr. Chad Marshall is quarterback sack sponsorship. Every quarterback sack the Indians have, Dr. Chad Marshall donates $50 to the touchdown club. So twins to either side, third down. Call a little over 20 to go for the Marlins. They'll empty the backfield. And here he goes. And down he goes at the 26-yard line. Saunders called his own number. Indians didn't bite. We stayed home.
Good job by Trent Eakes. He's done a great job at the linebacker spot. He and Richie Grant squeeze him in to the alley and make the tackle.
So Richie Grant will drop back around his own 40-yard line to receive the punt. Trevor Kilcrease. And play will stop temporarily. We'll see what's going on. I've got to speak with Coach. Marlins take a timeout. I got to talk with special teams coach tonight. He said, you know, the word's out on us. And I said, you're going to get a punt. He says, everybody's kicking it fast.
And
Coach Hendricks, he said, the kicker from Rickards took a two-step approach. And so they're going to get it out quick.
They took the timeout. They only had 10 guys on the field. So coach counted them out and got them out of a bad position. Sorry.
Hey, the Arnold AJ Spirit Shack, Choctaw AJ Spirit Shack's open the south end zone with a new line of Choctaw 215 shirts, hoodies, hats, jerseys, tank tops, visors, caps, socks, pencils, pens, and iPhone covers. You name it, they got it. Shack will be open during all JV, varsity, and freshman football games this season. Congratulations, the JV team beating Niceville yesterday.
You got to love that.
Ninth graders came up short, but JV won.
Anytime you can play them and beat them, it's a great day.
Yeah. High snap. We're coming. No, we're going to back away. High punt. Richie Grant waving frantically for a fair catch, and he falls down.
Lucky he didn't touch that.
Yeah.
That ball.
Richie Grant fell backwards at the 38-yard line, lost his balance, and the ball bounced. And Arnold, for some reason, they caught it on the bounce. They probably should have let that go a little more.
I think that would have kept bouncing at least 5 or 10 more yards. That ball was moon ball. That was really high.
Early score from across town at the Riggs. Fort Walton Beach up 7-0 over Navarre.
Wow.
The Vikings getting their first win in over a year last week. Double tights fairly on the spread option. He gets a big play. First down, a couple to spare. Up across the 40 to the 41, excuse me, 44-yard line. Actually, they'll spot it at the 43. No matter, chains will move.
Choctaw going, hurry up.
Single receiver to either side. Double tights handed inside to Kane. Marquise Kane, he has a first down with a yard or two to spare. Hold on to it, Marquise, and he does. Kane, a little fumble prone earlier, lost three of them. Had one that was down by contact that could have been called as one. Done a better job of holding on to it. Chains will move for the Indians, first and 10. Cross midfield in the 46 of Arnold. Minute four left to play, opening quarter. Play action, Fairley's rolling to his right. He's going to keep it. No, he's going to throw it. It's incomplete. Jake may have done better off tucking it and running than that one.
Yeah. He had some room up the right side, but as a quarterback, he's coached keep your eyes downfield and try to throw it. So you can't fault him on that. A lot of times in high school, they're running it way before they think about throwing it.
Second and 10. Richie Grant's in the slot to the left. Vidal Merrill, wide left. Twins right. Out of the spread from the 46. Quick hitter out in the flat. Richie Grant, he dances. Richie Grant's across the 40. Richie Grant's across the 30. He's taken down by his jersey at the 25.
That was close to going the distance. Peyton Pipes, senior defensive back, came across the field to make the tackle, but if he could have got just a little bit cleaner out of his break, he was going to go the distance on that one.
46 seconds left to go. We'll have it at the 24 here in the opening quarter. Trips right. Single receiver left is Pickett. Oh, excuse me, that's Merrill. Pump fake, we're going for the corner. Going to hitch and go.
What a catch.
Catch it at the one. How about that? Richie Grant again caught that one at the one.
Richie bailed Jake out on that one. It was old pump and go. They've been throwing that quick screen. He went upfield. If he throws it with air into the end zone, it's an easy touchdown. He threw a line drive. Richie Grant had to make a diving catch, and it was fantastic. Here we go. Got some instant replay.
And we bring in the beef out of the eye. Left side, not much air.
Fumbled it.
Arnold's saying they have it.
They do.
Kane fumbled it, and they do. At the one-yard line, Marquise Kane fumbled it. That's his fourth of the year.
I would make him take his gloves off. I didn't see the collision. I was looking at the monitor to see the replay. Did he get blasted?
We brought in Godfrey to run the power eye, the fridge, and went away from him to the left side, and Marquise just lost the handle on it when he got hit. With 22 seconds to play here, opening quarter, Indians lead 7-0. And talk about a long field, the Marlins will have just that.
Hold on,
man. Ball's inside the one. Couldn't have fumbled it any closer to the goal line.
No, you couldn't pick it up and down it any closer. So look for your quarterback sneak out of Saunders here, and he'll line up in the spread. Figured he'd just try to sneak it out to get some little breathing room. They're going to throw it. First down, complete, out in the flat, tackled at the 5.
I think that's Richie Grant over there.
Richie Grant's doing it all on this drive for the offense, and now first play, tackled on defense. And that's going to do it for one quarter of play here at Joe Etheredge Stadium. Clock winds down, and that's it. Indians lead it 7-0. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on EmeraldCoastTV.com. At Joe Etheredge, one quarter is in the books. Indians lead at 7-0. The Marlins, we fumbled it on their 1 yard line, so they've got it second down and 5 from their own 6. Saunders, the West Virginia commit at quarterback. Thompson's is running back. Twins left, twins right. Thompson will get this one. Dances outside. Tackled at the 10. Well, that'd be third and a yard.
We went with an eight-gap blitz there. Quarterback did a good job reading it. They gave him a first down.
Well, that gave him a very good spot. Chains will move. First and 10, and Coach Thomas kind of scratching his head. Chains shirts on us tonight. He's got a neon yellow glow-in-the-dark shirt. Asked me what color it was. I said, what color? He says, I'm colorblind. I said, well, that's like a glow-in-the-dark black light Jimi Hendrix shirt or something.
I like the gold one better.
Yeah. Problem is, I don't think he can find it. Saunders. Now he'll run left. Saunders has some running room. He's got a first down across the 21. That'll be close. And a little extracurricular activity after the play ended.
So it's either a block in the back or we're going to get called for trying to hit him out of bounds. We didn't hit him. We tried to. So is it a block in the back or is it we tried to hit him?
In 7-0 early on here. First half, early in the second quarter, and that's going to be a holding against the Indians.
They gave it a personal foul. It's 15.
It's a personal foul, excuse me.
See, we were hustling. Joey White was coming on the sidelines. Looked like he got pushed, barely touched the quarterback, who clearly was out of bounds, but there was no real contact.
So the Marlins swim out of a deep fishing hole, and now they're heading upstream toward the north end zone.
We bailed them out on that one.
Trips left, single receiver right, first and 10. A minute gone here in the second quarter. Saunders keeps it himself, fights for a couple. Saunders tough sledding up there when you go at it by yourself.
Number 75, Jason Godfrey.
This kind of things that drive Coach Thomas and any coach crazy when you make mistakes shooting yourself in the foot. Fumbling and careless penalties giving the other team, giving them opportunities to come back and beat you.
Want to get off that field and you can't do it. Second down, trips right, single receiver left. Thompson's in the backfield with Saunders. Now they'll go empty. He'll throw it out to Thompson in the flat.
Hit him right in his chest.
In the numbers, is anything whistle dead? It is. I thought it was his lateral for a second there.
Close. I think he was moving forward. Go trips to the right side. Motion him in that two-step motion. Look, it would have been a good play. But it hit him right in his chest, and he wasn't able to field it.
All right, big play for the Indians. Third and 6. Got to get off the field in third downs. Coach Thomas said that's been the prescription the last 3 weeks. Can't leave these guys out here too long. Twins to either side for Saunders. 5 on the play clock. Saunders. Yeah, quarterback draw himself, keeps it. Wasn't designed that way. He's going to be about a yard short unless they get another incredible spot.
Kalen Lovett came in and really popped his right thigh hard. Sent him kind of head over heels, heels over head. Good pop by Kalen Lovett.
All right, 4th and a yard.
Going for
Marlins
it.
Are going to go for it. Coach Josh Wright says, let's pull the trigger here. See if they get the Indians to jump off sides. They'll look to the side for the play. 4th and a yard from inside their own territory. 9:46 to play, opening half. We lead it 7-0. Quarterback sneak. And we'll see.
Ooh, it's going to be close.
That will be close.
Oh, the far hash mark gave him a good spot. I don't know, that might be short.
We will see. I think they're going to bring the chains out and check this one out.
It's going to be right on it.
We mentioned the quarterback sack sponsorship. Don't forget the defensive turnover sponsorship. Keith Anchors and Gordon, the law firm. $25 to the Touchdown Club for every defensive turnover created. Also, the Rise Up Award. The Rise Up Award for a Choctawhatchee High School football player is selected by the coaching staff each week. The award theme mirrors the FCA camp's mantra of rise up recognizing that young man's athletic performance and, more importantly, his character, integrity, and classroom performance. The Rise Up Award is sponsored by Jeff McDonald of ENG Lending, who provides a T-shirt. The Indians will get it on downs. How about that? Turnover on downs.
I mean, inches. Inches.
Lux Sports Grill, a gift card to the restaurant, and also the Trophy Center, who donates a trophy. The winner this week is Richie Grant. So Richie Grant is the Rise Up winner this week. He joins Marquise Kane, Kaylin Lovett, John Bernay, and Isaac Smith, and Jake Fairley as the winners of that prestigious award this year.
Good job, Richie. Class individual.
I formation up the middle. There's Kane. He's got four up to the 39, maybe five. Put some duct tapes on that, holding those hands and hold on to the ball. Second down. Call it a long five for the Indians.
Second down, 6 yards.
At the 41. We lead it 7-0 here in the second quarter. Marquise again out of the eye. There goes Marquise. He's going to go to the house. 10, 5, touchdown.
All right, we forgive him for the fumble. He's concentrating on holding on tight. He's going through the line of scrimmage with two hands on it. Good job by the offensive line and fullback getting the linebacker. Team effort there. Great run. Good job execution.
13-0. Hunter Merrill will snap it. Richie Grant will hold it. Mendoza will do the honors. It's up. It's good. 14-0 here in the second quarter. Indians on top. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on ECITV.com. Indians score. Marquise Kane again. This touchdown drive brought to you by John Dowd, attorney at law.
Again, a quick 30-second drive. Marquise Kane gets two carries, goes 51 yards. The second carry, the 46-yard touchdown run, gives the Indians a 14-0 lead with 8:57 left in the first half.
Good news for the guys in green with the black pants and the black hats.
Yeah, nice looking uniform.
Mendoza. Tee it up on the right hash. We'll see if he can put one in the end zone. It looks like this one may go for a ride, and it does. How about that?
Wow,
maybe his deepest kickoff of the year.
That was 8 yards deep. Rolled even with the
golf flag, so he caught a flyer.
He did. He got it in that rough and popped it.
We're without our Lee Nissan scoring updates tonight. We're relying on ScoreStream app, which can be on the honor system because it's reported in like gas, buddy. But the score system is saying, ScoreStream, 24-14, Crestview over Pace right now. So that's what they're saying.
Bulldogs.
Randy Dixon up there on the coverage for the Crestview News Leader. The Bulletin. Option play. Late pitch. And taken out of bounds. Whoa, let's see. Nope, that's going to be at the 28-yard line, but no late flag. Joey White on the tackle. First, that should be enough for a first down. Now they're going to say he's short.
Went out of bounds about the 28.
Second down and two. Indians leading 14-0 here. A little over 3 minutes gone in the second quarter. This one's going to stop before it got started.
Two men in motion.
Dylan Gandy was in motion.
They've got a nice little offense. They spread you out and they'll bring a slot receiver in motion and run the like the wishbone option with them.
As Coach Thomas used to say about West Florida Tech, they do what they do, you know? They do what they do, and they're going to do it well. Arnold Marlins out of Panama City Beach. Fun place to visit. Nice hospitality in the press area. Keeper up the middle. Quarterback keeper the whole way. We're about 2, maybe 3 yards goes Saunders over right tackle. Again, we're simulcasting tonight on Emerald Coast TV, so we're trying to bring a radio feed to those listening on the radio and not over-describe it to those who are watching live on that World Wide Web.
Not having much success with that. I got one track, radio.
Third down, four to go. Twins split to either side of the field. They'll motion receiver back, so we'll have dual setbacks next to Saunders. Handoff going to be short of a first down by about a yard and a half.
Handed off to Juwan White, their leading receiver.
His second carry of the year.
Yeah, I'd like to see Jaquan Thompson carry it there, but they run White. He comes up a yard short.
So a fourth down, they'll say no Moss at this time. They're going to kick it. Kilcrease in to do the honors.
He boomed one last time.
Richie Grant, it was so high, I think he got dizzy. A little bit of vertigo watching that one come down. And we've got more whistles before anything happens.
Timeout, Marlins.
Timeout, Marlins. Great time for one of our player profiles. We've got a couple tonight. Bonus night because it's Hall of Fame night.
Yeah, let's do this one. You mentioned him earlier. Been a tough football player for the Indians. Richie Grant. He plays quarterback in the Wildcat, wide receiver, and corner on defense. He's been playing football since he was 7 years old. That's 11 years. Best football memory, the first time losing. Taught me to be humble but hungry. You gotta like that. He's got a 3.0 GPA and he likes all of his teachers. His favorite subject is arithmetic. Favorite food, shrimp and chicken Alfredo. Favorite restaurant, anything Chinese.
There you go.
Some great Alfredo at that Chinese place up the road here. Favorite college team, the Crimson Tide. Doesn't care for the NFL. Person he most admires, his uncle. And what he likes doing when he's not playing football, hanging around with family. After graduation, he'd like to become a successful businessman after he plays college football. Best thing about Choctaw, the tradition. Best feeling in the world, playing for people in the community and prior teams that have played.
Kilcrease kind of lets this one go off the side of his foot. Richie will take it at the 41, and down he goes at the 44. So nothing bad there, nothing good there, but good field position for the Indians.
Good job by Richie fielding that one.
Text line is open. Just got a text from class of 76, Bob Campbell, local moving and storage magnate. They're telling me the helmets were doing a good job.
Thank you.
I don't know if he's watching or listening. I don't know. One or the other. There's only two ways to do it.
76, they were good football team back in 76.
Yeah, we hope to have a halftime interview with that bunch. That would have been 40 years ago. Coming up for that Fort Walton game when the class of 76, the year before the state championship run in 77, I formation. Fake, throws out in the flat, complete. Nice running. 23, Zach Childers, the sophomore, going to be good for an Indian first down out of the 38-yard line.
I like Zach. He's come in and done well in spurts. Zach Childers, he's 160-pound sophomore. Got to love being on the varsity as a sophomore playing fullback.
Yeah, they got him in the up back. First and 10 out of the eye. This is where Kane is loving it so far. Play action. Oh, we go. Yeah, down he goes. We try to end around to Isaac Smith, and sitting there waiting on him was a Marlin. It looked like one in a bad mood.
Taylor Cook, a 6'1", 190-pounder. And I watched on that play. They don't have he's not listed on this roster. Let me check another one. But Zach Childers came from his fullback spot and met the defensive end head on Tyler Minshew. That was a collision.
Second down, 14 to go. Kane bounces it outside. Marquise Kane back to the original line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard after that, and that's about it. Indians lead it 14 to nothing here in the second quarter.
Third,
6 minutes, 11 seconds, and time to pause to refresh. It's time for another hydration break. This one brought to you by Grayson Bowman Orthodontics. Dr. Grace and Dr. Brody Bowman right next door to Choctawhatchee High School. They'll work on the mouth. Yeah, let's go ahead and go number two.
Let's see if I can get through it.
Yeah.
I like watching this kid play. He's getting better and better each week. Defensive end, Trey Broadwater. He's been playing football for only 4 years. That's why every time he steps on the field, he improves. And his best football memory, beating Fort Walton at their field for the first time last year. His favorite subject is English. Favorite food, hamburgers. And this guy I love. Favorite restaurant, where do you get a good hamburger? Yeah. Five Guys. So he's got it right.
Five Guys and a wheelbarrow of fries.
Favorite college team, the Oregon Ducks, the New England Patriots. Person he most admires, Lawrence Taylor. We'll get him coming back after this.
Yeah, we'll wrap that player profile up after we have some action quick after the quick hydration break. Twins to either side, third down, nine to go. Jake Fairley, three-step drop, looking, starting to set up the screen underneath and dropped in his hands. Colby Dorsey going for the, Richie Grant going for the wide receiver screen.
Yeah, they're trying a little underneath Rocket Ishmael wide receiver screen. Lou Holtz, Notre Dame, made that one famous. He just couldn't hold on. The defensive line did a great job putting pressure on Fairley.
Now it's fourth down, short field to go. Fairley's in punt formation, and Coach Thomas said this is where they have some packages off of this. So we'll see if Jake indeed boots this one or if we see something out of this. Indians lead at 14-0. Low snap. Fairley does boot it. Nice spiral tuck. Fair catch at the 11-yard line. Okay, so no harm.
Kill crease. Fair catches it. Wrapping up the player profile. And what Trey Broadwater likes doing when he's not playing football, he'd like to continue being around the sport he loves, coaching. So when he's finished playing football, he wants to be a coach. And after graduation, he wants to work towards a sports agent or personal trainer or a degree in education. Best thing about Choctaw, the hard work, effort, and discipline that the coaches instill in them each day. Trey Broadwater.
Trey Broadwater. What's the hang around sports? Special congratulations to Sarah Gates, daughter of Mike Gates and Cindy Gates, a principal here, just got accepted into the Graduate School of Sports Management at Florida State.
Nice.
That's what she wants to do. Pass is there. No one's home.
Colby hit him a little early. We're going to get a little pass interference or defensive holding on that one.
Sort this one out. Next week, fun continues. We head to Crestview. Dogs, I don't know where we'll be doing that game from. They have they've got good boiled peanuts, but nowhere for us to sit as far as the press box. So who knows? We may do this one from the field. Who knows?
Last time we were there, Tom, we did it in the stands.
And holding is the call.
It was a nice atmosphere until about the third quarter, and one of those yahoos figured out that we were on the radio and stood right beside us. Crowd mic cheering as loud as he could every time Crestview did something good.
We'll see. Maybe we'll take it. Maybe we'll take it on the sideline.
Either sideline or I'm going to find a good bodyguard and keep them cleared away from the crowd mic.
First and 10 from the 22 after the defensive holding call. Saunders going to tuck this one and throw it complete at the 39. Knocked back to the 38. So it's going to be good for a Marlin first down.
Man, you can see the athleticism of Cody Saunders on that play. We had him dead to right in the backfield, and Gabe Estes was in hot pursuit. He sidestepped him, kept his eyes downfield, threw a strike right to the intended receiver, Paul Patterson. First down for the Marlins.
5.5 minutes to play here in the opening half. Indians lead it 14-0. Marlins have threatened several times, but the drives have stalled. Incomplete and almost intercepted.
That one was hot. Dylan Gandy got a hand on it for the Marlins, and the tip, Miles Betts would have made a...
He had a shot at it.
Standing one-handed grab. His body was going away from the football, but he was athletic enough to put the hand up and almost get it.
Coach Chip Petrie doing his best Kirby Smart impersonation. He is going on the sidelines. His arms are going, signaling into plays, getting them jacked up, getting them in position. Second down, 10 to go. Saunders.
Couldn't
get him, and now we do get him back at the 32-yard line.
I mean, there were several Indians getting after him. Kalen Lovett, the big sophomore, Jason Godfrey, and Gabe Estes were swarming him like killer bees.
Third down, long. Call it 16. Another $25 from Dr. Chad Marshall goes to the quarterback club, touchdown club, excuse me. Third down and 16 after that sack. Saunders sends twins to either side. 4:43 and counting here in the first half. Saunders looking to throw. We've got pressure again. He's going to launch this one, throws it complete, and can't hold on at the 44-yard line.
Tried to keep his feet in, unable to do so.
So fourth down. That means Richie Grant will try not to get dizzy again. One of these high punts.
Kilcrease
caught a little vertigo on that second punt. Kilcrease will catch it around his 24, but we're going to play it stopped with a lot of whistles out there.
Backing him up. Five for some reason.
Back him up to the 33-yard line. Again, simulcast night on Emerald Coast TV and also on WPSM, our home for the now the 12th consecutive year. Hopefully next year we make it a baker's dozen, huh? Good snap, no pressure. High kick, Richie Grant, fair catch, and ooh, he caught that one at the 35 and a half.
Good job. Anytime you field those punts, save it from hitting one of your teammates or the big roll that they get where you lose 15, 20 extra yards. So great job being in the right position to make the fair catch.
Mark Pennington, number 55, a 6 foot 210 offensive lineman. He's the first one on the field. He couldn't wait to get in there. .420 to play opening half. Indians, see if we can get another one before halftime from our 35. Childers is in the backfield alongside Jake Fairley. We'll send hard motion and fake the jet sweep. Fairley looking for a cut over the middle. Going to Pickett. Pickett had a step on his man. Jake just couldn't hit him.
Jake got hit hard by Minshew, and he couldn't get off of his back foot, get up on that front foot to get enough oomph on it. Pickett was open, ran a post. Good play action pass. He beat Kilcrease, but the pass was about 3 yards short.
Second down, twins left, twins right. Childers inside. Little sophomore keeps chugging those feet. He's got about 8 yards.
Good job. Immediately after he took the handoff, had to sidestep a defender. Showed good quickness. Picks up about 8.
Sheriff Larry Ashley down there talking to Mike Gates. Those two had a long week.
Unfortunately.
Unfortunate is indeed. Third down. Quick hitter out in the flat.
Uh-oh.
Pickett. Pickett's got a first down. He's stiff-arming, and he's ridden out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Good enough for an Indian first down. 3:39. Lots of time left. Indians lead at 14-0. Spread formation again. Childers in the backfield. We'll send rip motion. We'll hand it to him this time. That's Richie Grant on the jet sweep. He cuts it back inside. Gets a couple down to the 31. Second down. 6 to go for the Indians as the clock's under 3.25 to play. Trips to the left side. Jake Fairley. Inside to Childers. That little guy's running hard. He's going to get near a first down. Going to be about a yard short.
And I like his quick feet.
I like his granddad. His granddad sitting down there with his Childers jersey on. And that guy's a spitting image of my late father-in-law. I'm going to stop him one day and show him a picture. And if somebody in the world that looks just like you, well, here he is. Third and a yard, a long yard for the Indians. 2:45 to play. Double tights. We're going out of the eye. Marquise Kane goes nowhere. He goes backwards.
Dalton Likens. 5'9", 185-pound linebacker. Hit him in the backfield.
Coach Thomas wants to talk about it. Probably a good idea. Again, the way that schedule sets up for the Indians, district play starts next week. At the only field in Okaloosa County, or the only field in a lot of places that runs east and west, not north and south, at Crestview. And the Indians have a week to get healthy. And then it's back on the road at Niceville on the 16th. We host Tate homecoming night here on the 23rd. Everybody's having their class reunions and everything that weekend. And then the Fort Walton Beach Vikings get on the bus, come across town on the 30th for senior night, and then the Indians will close it out, close the regular season out at Mosley. Indians the last 2 weeks have done something that hasn't been done very often lately. They lost two in a row.
Yeah, that just growing pains, and you have to have every facet of the game going, offense, defense, kicking. And
I gotta say, Kane lost 3 yards on that play, so it's fourth down and looks like a short four.
2:33. What are we gonna run?
High formation. Childers is your up back. Toss sweep to Marquise. Marquise bowls his way. He's going to be short of a first down. Not even close. So the Indians will turn it over on downs. And the Marlins will take over.
That was our seventh possession of the first half.
14 points to show for it. So the Marlins from Panama City Beach. And their Division I quarterback, Cody Saunders, will have it with one more try here to close out the first half. They desperately need to get some points. Spread formation, Saunders looking all the way, looking left all the way. He's got his man, incomplete. Oh, had him on the fingertips and dropped it at the 48. Laid out Dylan Gandy.
Couldn't get there. He was open. He ran four verticals. Put it close. Just couldn't make it. It would have been a fantastic catch.
Second and 10.
Hard to believe going through that schedule. This is the fifth game of the season.
Yeah, how time flies. Come on, Kane! Out of the spread. Three-step drop, looking. Fires this one deep and picked off by Richie Grant. And down Richie Grant goes at the 35. So the Indians have 2 minutes and 11 seconds and 64 yards to get some more points.
Start their eighth possession of the first half.
Defensive turnover again. That means $50 in the coffers from Keefe Anchors and Gordon Law Firm. Currently, Niceville up on Tate 6-0. First quarter score from over in Cantonment. Gonzalez, or whatever you like to call it.
I haven't been to Tate since played there my senior year.
Now you got about 54 weeks, and we're going to do it. Twins left, twins right, fairly out of the gun. Barks count, rolls to his left, throws it out in the flat, complete. Richie Grant fights for a couple more yards. Is that Verdell Merrill? That's Richie Grant. Marker comes in late. See over around where Richie caught it. Might be a face mask. We'll see.
Personal foul, 15-yard variety. Against the Marlins.
First down, Indians. So 119 ticks left here in the first half. And the Indians just got a freebie. They'll march into Marlin territory at the 43-yard line.
Had several guys from the 1990 team come to town. We're going to try to talk to as many as we can at halftime. Should be entertaining.
Yeah, hopefully we'll get them up here and get to interview them live. And Marquise Kane.
Turn the microphone over to Coach Peters and let it roll.
You could turn the microphone over to Coach Peters and just take your car down to that Tom Thumb and get some gas. Second down. He's done a fantastic job organizing this reunion for the 25th anniversary of state championship team. Fairly second and 10. Breakthrough Kane. Kane dances. Kane at the 30. Kane down to the 28-yard line. Clock will stop as the chains move. First and 10 Indians.
Kane spinning, twisting, turning, inventing.
14-0, Indians lead it. Minute 30 and change here in the opening half.
Jump cut.
Play action. Fairley throws it off his back foot. He's got Richie Grant. He couldn't hang on. Richie Grant saying, man, you got to go to me every play.
Illegal hands in the face. I don't know if that's a high school penalty, but he had his helmet knocked off. I should know his name already. Mark Pennington, tackle, blocking on number 25, Minshew. Minshew put his hand on the face mask, knocked his helmet off. Kept playing. He was worried he was going to get a penalty on him, but no, the ref said, stay in, Mark. You're going to continue to play since you got your helmet pushed off your head.
Cole Cruz will check in at wide receiver. He'll line up way to the left. In the slot goes Richie Grant. First and 10 Indians from the 14-yard line out of the spread. We lead at 14-0. Had another gift here. Jake hands off. Kane up the middle. Marquise dances. Tries to do something. Invent something. Nothing there. Stop for no gain.
Minshew again comes in. Makes the tackle.
Minute 12 and counting.
Tyler Minshew, the defensive end, playing a good ball game for the Arnold Marlins.
Indians getting the play from the sideline. Second down. 9 to go.
Under a minute to play.
From the 12-yard line. Twins to either side, out of the spread. Fairley's going to run the option. Calls his own number. Down he goes. Got to the 10, and that's about it. Right in the middle of the field.
Coach is letting the clock tick. Takes a timeout.
Tackle by number 32, Chandler Marshall. Timeout, Choctaw.
Other games in the area of note this evening. Listening area. Niceville, as we mentioned, is at Tate. Navarre is at Fort Walton Beach. Pace is at Crestview. Baker at Rocky Bayou. It's bye week in Freeport, South Walton, and Walton. Guess they're all home watching film. And the 2-1 Weewaw Hitchcock Fighting Gators are at North Bay Haven.
Weewaw.
We are Weewaw, the Fighting Gators. We'll go at you a little later on tonight with our prognostications and predictions for this week.
I'm going to get serious.
Ole Miss threw us a curveball last week, didn't they?
Yeah.
Alabama did with 5 turnovers.
I should have picked Ole Miss. Yeah. Hindsight being 2020.
Oh, boy, it'll be another great weekend of college football this week. Big game in the Southeastern Conference. Mississippi State is at Auburn. Auburn just electing to change up the quarterback.
I would be surprised at all if Mississippi State goes in there and gives it a month.
Everybody's ready to go except the white hat. He's taking his time and having a conversation with the side judge on the east end of the field. Third down. 6 to go for the Indians from the 10-yard line. Need to get to the 4 for a first down. Under a minute to play. Jake Fairley puts Pickett in motion. Pickett on this jet sweep. Chris Pickett's trying to create something, and he can't get anything. He actually loses 4 yards on the play.
Kick a field goal.
So Mendoza, it'll be Jose's time. See if he can put 3 more points on the board. Jose. Last big field goal against Pine Forest earlier to close that deal. 36-yarder from the right hash.
14 seconds. Play clock's not going to start. It's going to run it down to about 4 seconds and call time.
And Coach Thomas does exactly that. Takes timeout with 3.3 seconds. It'll be a fast timeout.
And this is what they need. Crucial for them to be able to snap it, put it on the tee, and get a good clean sweep of the leg and kick it, get a field goal. It's been, good Lord, has it been since the first game that we had a field goal? Game winner.
Yeah.
Remember that one. But
I just hope he has ice water in his veins again.
I do too.
Yeah.
I want the long snapper to have ice water in his veins.
Hunter Merrill.
And snap it back there.
Now, the Indians have been plagued by special team.
You take it
differences
for granted.
With regard to holders. Richie Grant went out. He was out for a week and a half. And we had Isaac Smith holding and just and a couple kickers and David Sherman and Mendoza. So it's been a menagerie of things on special teams. So that
you take it for granted when you go out there and you're like clockwork, you snap it, kick it, snap it, place it, kick it, everything works. But when you can't do it, it's just hard to compete in crucial games when you need three or you got to get some points. The confidence you get and from not being able to kick a field
from the left hash 21-yard line. It'll be a 31-yard attempt. Snap is good. Placement's good. The kick is up. It's spinning. No good. Wide right.
He missed it right.
So special team woes continue, but we'll take it to halftime. In 2 minutes, we'll have a live interview with Coach Jeff Peters. We call him the coach, former coach here, and former quarterback of that state championship team. Your score, 14-0, Indians. We'll be back in 2 minutes. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Bay District Schools Superintendent, Mr. Bill Husfeldt, and J.R. Arnold High School Principal, Mr. Keith Blandon, we proudly present to you the Blue Thunder Band. Tonight, we present to you our 2015 show, Taboo, featuring trumpet soloist Gabe Phelps, Chase Gilmore, Samantha Finch, Catherine Pride, and trombone soloist Lauren Stewart and Alan Sin. Drum major Samantha Finch and Andrew DeShield. Is the band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Thunder Band! Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, under the field direction of drum major Stephen Foster, Choctawhatchee High School proudly presents the Style Marchers.
Thank you.
The Style Marchers would like to thank the greatest support group in the world, our parents, for all their love, support, and energy.
Well, welcome back to Joe Etheredge Stadium after a long and memory lane ride down halftime.
I tell you, it's gone on and on.
Indians on top 14-0. Here we lost the toss to start the game. The Arnold Marlins deferred. They won the toss, so they will get it to start the second half, and Mendoza will boot it. The Indians 14-0 on the back of Marquise Kane. Two touchdown runs for the junior. Mendoza likes kicking it that way. Nikes takes it down the five. They will reverse it or fake the reverse.
That's a reverse. Nope.
The fake reverse, and he's going up the right sideline, and we bit. He's at the 40, knocked out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Haven't seen that one yet this year.
They did a really good job faking it.
We couldn't tell who had it.
Gilchrist acted like he reversed it, put the ball on his thigh and kept it there, just kind of jogged up the sideline. The Indians were running to the fake reverse guy.
Again, we are simulcasting this game tonight on WPSM, our broadcast partner for the 12th year now, and also with R.J. Murdoch and his team at Emerald Coast TV. You know, the bandwidth doesn't come free. And special thanks to Okaloosa Gas for stepping up and sponsoring the streaming the internet tonight. That's very nice of the folks out there in Valpee, pass complete out in the flat. Also, the Choctawhatchee media students work for Miss Hillary Sintes. They provide the cameras and the switching and all that good stuff. So it's a team effort.
Okay, doing a good job. Got a fine picture tonight.
Yeah, second down. Six to go in two plays. A kickoff return and one play. The Marlins have swam upstream, swimming north in the Indian territory. Three-step drop over the middle, caught and dropped at the 35-yard line. Saunders put it right on the money.
Dylan Gandy's having a rough go of it tonight. Couldn't make that one happen. Possibly heard footsteps. Sanders put it right on the money.
Hall of Fame night. Hall of Fame night here in the Chateau as far as menu goes. Well, we had the jambalaya going, crawfish pies, had some wings. Of course, the appetizers, popcorn and peanuts.
Out did it tonight. Boy. Chef Tom Brassell.
Coach Utter busted his diet next door. We came by and grazing for a bit. Lunch line right to the right. Trips are lined up in I formation. He'll throw a quick screen out in the flat, try to get two blocks. Indians read it well, but it's going to be right near the first down marker at the 45.
It's a quick pivot by the quarterback and threw it out in the flats to not on the roster.
Unknown man, yeah. Had an interesting run of it tonight with rosters from Panama City. Arnold had one roster on Max Preps. They sent us a corrected roster, and the corrected roster didn't have some numbers on it. They got a timeout for measurement.
It's going to be right on it. Looks a couple inches short.
Yeah. You know, this broadcast is being brought to you by the Choctawhatchee Touchdown Club. Intended solely for the enjoyment of our listening audience. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of this broadcast without the express written consent of the Choctawhatchee Touchdown Club, WPSM Radio, Emerald Coast TV, and PanhandleEasyStream.com is prohibited. I think it's going to be just short by inches. R.J. Murdoch's getting a good look at it with the camera, and that's it, just a couple inches. Shine, there's the Hall of Famer out there in the stands, sitting there and enjoying the camaraderie of some of his old players.
Yeah, 9 or 10 of them came back into town and enjoying it.
Fourth and inches, and it's go time for the Marlins. Up till now, that means Cody Saunders getting under center and just taking it himself. That's exactly, he's where he's going to line up. He's not even remotely handed the ball off yet when he's gotten under center. It's been quarterback sneaking the whole way.
We're loading that A and B gap up.
Fourth and inches.
Tough time.
There he goes, right up the gut. And he's got it. Oh, look at some second, third effort. Saunders, he's still not down. Finally taken down by Godfrey.
I think there's a little early whistle, but they're going to spot it at the 39. Low man wins. He got the leverage. He was underneath the defense and pushed him for about 4 yards.
Play stopped temporarily while the chain gang does their thing on the far side. First and 10. Saunders will line up. Twins right and twins left. Thompson's in the backfield with him. He'll put motion and run the option right side. Keeps it. And down he goes after a 1 yard gain.
Colby Dorsey scraped outside and was right there where he's supposed to be to take the quarterback. Put him form tackled. Good job by Colby. He's a fine football player and he's a better kid.
He's got that old-fashioned neck roll on the backside. He's got a Sharpie with a hashtag GATA on it.
He did lie. He had a big smile when I told him that was a 90 team with GATA. Get after them aggressively.
There you go. That's the clean version. Second down.
It's the only version.
Yeah. Option right side. Some running room. First down and a couple to spare. Down across the 30 to the 29-yard line.
A little more speed from that number 28. Got the pitch and accelerated upfield. Trey Broadwater wasn't able to contain. Corner Richie was downfield covering.
Again, we're saying 28 because we're not sure. The roster sent over today had no number 28 on it. Now, lunch line left, trips left. They'll try the quick hitter out in the flat. And, boy, Kalen Lovett sniffed that one out like a bulldog sniffing steak.
Juwan White caught it, and immediately Kalen Lovett was on his back. Good job. Kalen Lovett was one of those guys we talked about last year, his first year playing the varsity level or much football at all, and man, he got better each game. Still doing that. Each time he steps on the football field, he gets better and better.
Yeah, Kalen Lovett, a confessed basketball junkie, came out to play football, and boy, he's been a nice find for the Indians.
Second down, 13 yards to go.
Second and 13, 8:29 to play here in the third quarter. Indians lead at 14-0. Option right side. Oh boy, this one's going to go to the house. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, touchdown. 33-yard touchdown run for Cody Saunders.
If you give him some space, he's one of those quick cutters. He sees it and goes straight there. Enough speed and athleticism to finish that run off.
14-6, just like that. Getting a man on late. Point after attempt will be by Nick Guzman. Snap is good. Placement's good. The kick is up, and it is good. So just like that, it's a one-score game. 14-7 Indians back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on on EmeraldCoastTV.com. Well, the east side of the stadium got something to get excited about, a 33-yard touchdown run by Cody Sanders to cut the lead to 14-7 here in the third quarter.
Yeah, Marlins go 55 yards in 8 plays, 3 minutes and 40 seconds, big touchdown run by Cody Sanders.
And they go onside kick. We fall on it right at the 50. So the good hands team in there for the Indians. Nice play by Colby Dorsey. Good field position for the Indians.
Right at midfield.
Marlins trying to catch us asleep. Fairley will bring us up in the eye, which has worked pretty well tonight. So far. Turner's back in at fullback. Canes will be the tailback when we get this thing going. We're not there yet. Zach Nash, your tight end on the right side, twin receivers left. Kane up the middle. There's Marquise, and he's got some running room. Marquise, hold on to the ball. He doesn't. It's stripped out. And it's recovered by the Marlins back at the 10-yard line. There's no review of this.
That was
in high school.
A great job by the defensive back. He came in and ripped hard at it. You know, Marquise is going to, at some point, it's going to be in his psyche about fumbling, but that was just a great play by the defensive back. Great run, great blocking. Just great play by the defensive back.
Can't tell you how the frustration level with coaching staff with that. You teach it and you preach it. Then you get a reputation for putting the ball on the ground and the other team's going to keep coming at you.
Yep.
14-7. Just under 8 minutes to play here. Second possession of the quarter, of the third quarter for the Marlins. Saunders just keeps it right up the middle. Again, he is the leading rusher for the Arnold Marlins.
Big, strong kid.
Kind of Gorntoe-ish.
Yeah.
Yeah, 6'1", 210, 2'5".
Tad bit more. Gorntoe's true fullback-esque.
Yeah.
He's got a little bit of shake to him.
Saunders keeps it himself. Down he goes this time. Little Quint Gorntoe dressing out in Florida wearing number 22.
Nice. Trey Broadwater on the tackle there. Got him in the backfield. He's 22, huh? I'll have to check him out tomorrow.
Third down. He's been working those signals for Coach Jim McElwain's offense. Third down and 6 for the Marlins here in the third quarter. Indians lead at 14-7. Saunders out of the spread. Looking to pass. Complete. Tackled by Gabe Estes. Estes is signaling short. I'm not sure where the spot's going to be. It's going to be close.
Good job by Saunders. He ran the...
Or Trent Eakes on the tackle. Excuse me.
Gandy ran the 8-yard turnaround, and Saunders threw him open through to his outside shoulder. Defense was on the inside, and Gandy's able to hang on to that one. He's dropped a few tonight, but caught that one, and they'll measure again.
Yeah, I got the over-under on measurements tonight. They've had a bunch of them. Again, next week we're in Crestview's normal time. Pre-game 6:40. Kickoff is at 7 o'clock. We'll be broadcasting it from somewhere inside the stadium there.
That Jack Foster?
Yeah.
I don't mind being on the sidelines, to be honest with you.
For some reason, I always call it Jack Russell.
Jack Russell Terrier.
Just short, so I'm sure this will be go time again. It's worked well for the Marlins. Saunders just pushing forward.
Indians in a dogfight. Had it commanding, I say commanding, 14-point lead at half.
Marlins. Could have been more. Missed a field goal, missed an opportunity here and there. And
fumbled on the one, on the goal line, really. The ball was literally on the goal line. But you play the cards, deal yourself, and they're battling right now. Got a fourth.
Fourth and inches for the Marlins here in the third quarter. 6:35 to play. Indians on top, 14-7. I think this game a lot closer than the Indians or the Indian fans would like to see, or thought it would be.
I knew they would be pretty good.
Saunders out of the spread. Hands it inside. Do we hold? The Indians look like we held.
We did. Great job by Eakes. Dropped him. Team, he tried to bounce it out, and Eakes pounced on him.
Not questioning a call, but I don't understand that one.
I agree wholeheartedly. I mean, they've had success with the quarterback sneak, getting him under the center and let the big man push his way through. They line it up in the shotgun, snap it deep, and hand it off, and he does not make it back to the line of scrimmage.
Defense. Score from Cantonment, 21-13, Niceville over Tate. Navarre having their way at Fort Walton Beach. Fort Walton had an early score, and since then it's been all Raiders, 28-7.
Navarre's got a good ball club.
Baker, 12-3 over Rocky Bayou. And Crestview, the Bulldogs, getting their step right before district play starts, meeting pace 38-21.
Be a ball game next week.
So the Indians take it on downs. I believe that's the third turnover on downs this game. We'll line up in the eye. Childers is the eye back. Turner up front, the fullback. He'll barrel for a couple yards.
They left Marquise. At some point, I knew Coach was going to have to do that.
Second down. Childers, your eye back. Turner, the up back. Bringing the house, Childers. Met head on with a blitzing linebacker. Got about a yard down to the 15.
Tackle by number 44, Jacob Abbott.
Jacob Abbott on the tackle.
Third down,
5'8", 170 linebacker.
He was blitzing that A-gap, and that's right where we were running that ISO.
Third down, 6 to go for the Tribe. We got Twins to either side here late in the third quarter. Lead it 14-7. They're bringing the house. Fairley's going to throw this one away. Childers gets it, and he goes at the 14. Reminiscent of the old misplay, just to throw it up in the air. Childers was there, made the catch.
Screen not developing fast enough for Fairley. He's having to backpedal 15 yards backwards.
Mendoza in to try the field goal from the right hash mark. 21-yard line.
0 for 2 tonight. See if we can get the snap, the hold, and the boot.
Hunter Merrill will snap it. Richie Grant will hold it. Good snap. The placement's down. The kick is up. It's high enough. It's long enough. It's good. The Indians get three finally.
Yes.
17-7. Your score will be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on Emerald Coast TV. Indians don't get a touchdown, but get three out of it. Jose Mendoza boots it through from 31 yards out.
Yeah.
That crack you hear means it's time for another Barks Root Beer, the official beverage of the Indian broadcast team.
Gotta love
the Diet Barks. Gotta go diet. Mendoza approaches it. He knocked one out of the end zone earlier. This one's gonna be high. Is it gonna be enough? No, it's gonna be taken at the 1 foot line. 10. Chased down and spun down at the 9-yard line. Colby Dorsey with the tackle.
Good job covering that kick.
Hashtag Colby.
Yeah. Yeah, Barks. They used to bottle that stuff in Biloxi. Used to drink it out of the bottle.
Remember, you bought us a bottle 2 years ago and it exploded in here.
Yeah.
It's like a science project. all over that nice white printed shirt Coach Thomas just gave us.
That was good.
Memory lane tonight. Out of the spread formation. Marlins and Cody Saunders now down 10. He's been an enigma. He looks so good at times, and other times his receivers let him down, or there'll be a play we just don't understand. It's a read option. Not much there for the running back, Thompson.
Pinned way down in their own territory.
Yeah, inside their 5. Indians again lead 17-10. Setting up for, I think it's going to be quite a district battle. 4 teams in the district for the Indians. Crestview, Niceville, Fort Walton, and the guys on the field right here. Incomplete.
Good call. Good play. Good break on the ball. Miles Betts went right.
Betts hit him right when the ball hit him.
Number 27, Miles Betts, depending on the play.
But a huge game next week, Tom, to get out and a good start to the district play. Got 3 district ball games. Vikings being one. Niceville Eagles and the Crestview Bulldogs. I'll tell you, we can't ask for more rivalry in the district than that.
Third and 12. Marlins backed up to their 4. Saunders takes the snap and he's going to tuck it and run. Nope, he's going to look to throw. He launches it and it's picked off. How about that? At the 28, reversing
watch out,
field.
Watch out.
And down he goes. Richie Grant.
Just hoping that he saw Trevor Kilcrease coming. A lot of times he's looking upfield, doesn't see that guy coming on the blind side, but he last minute turned to look. Great interception by Richie Grant.
And that ringing sound you hear is the cash register. Keith Ankerson Gordon, who just donated another $25 to the Touchdown Club for that defensive turnover. I formation. Childers is the I back. Play action to Childers, looking to throw. Complete. Hit the 15, down at the 8, 7, 6, 5.
Isaac Smith.
First ball going Isaac's way tonight.
Settled down in the soft spot of the defense and then picked up about 10 yards after the catch.
Isaac will split wide right. Wide left is Vidal Merrill. Tight end to your right side's Nash. Here's Childers. Childers dances inside the 5 down to the 3-yard line. Childers listed on your on the roster at 5'5", 260. I think they missed it by 100. We got to fix that.
I think
it's in Excel. I should be able to fix that.
5'6", 160.
Second down. Stay in the eye. Turner's your up back. Tailback is Childers. Childers gets it. Bulls his way into the touchdown. The sophomore goes in. 6 more for the Indians. That makes it 23-7.
Good job for the sophomore. Maybe his first touchdown as a varsity player, and he's excited. And big score for the Indians to get it to 23-7 with 2:48 left in the third.
Richie Grant will hold it. Hunter Merrill will snap it to try to make it 24. Will be the orange-cleated Mendoza. And he does just that. 24-7. Time for some more jambalaya. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network. Zach Childers goes in from 4 yards out to make it 24-7. This drive sponsored by Wesley McGrail and Wesley Attorneys at Law on Eglin Parkway.
That three-play, 27-yard drive took 45 seconds off the clock, set up by a big Richie Grant, INT, Indians 24, Marlins 7.
Mendoza kicks this one over everybody, 5 yards deep. He's got his confidence going now, 24-7 Indians, 2:48 to play here in quarter number three.
He did. He blasted that one. That's the second time he's kicked it in the end zone tonight. Kick team's done a great job. Finally got a field goal attempt with some success. Got 3 points on the board. Now in control.
Saunders all the way at quarterback. They've got him going all the way this year on their stats. No one else has taken a snap that we know of. He'll split twins to either side. They're looking to pass. He'll get on his horse and run it. He's got a couple and goes down hard after about 4, maybe 5 yards. You're checking this out on the monitors in here. You wouldn't believe it. These are high school youngsters running these cameras and working the board. They're doing a fantastic job.
They do. It's nice that he's doing that for these high school kids to get that experience and possibly set up a career path for
them.
They might not have known was there.
Yeah. Speaking of friends, shout out to our friend Andrew Dovin. Listens every game, watches every. Maybe me, maybe watching now. He's got his headset on at home, I know, but he's our favorite. Trips left. Saunders keeps it on the read option. There wasn't even an option. There's a keeper the whole way, and he gets about 10 yards. Good for a first down.
And he's smart. He's done it a couple of times. When he needs to get tough yardage, he will. He'll take on three guys if he has to. When there's nothing left and he can get out of bounds, he'll get out of bounds and save him. You know, save the hits that he takes. He carries the ball 20 times a game, 25 times a game, throws it. It's everything for him. So get out of bounds when you can.
First and 10. Marlins from the 35, their own 35. They trail 24-7. A hitch and go. He's going to lob this one up. It's fair game, out of bounds.
Good job by Miles Betts. Right there with him. Turned back, made a play on the ball. He's had a great game tonight, and he's getting better with each start. He's a junior playing corner. He's out on that island by himself. He's done a good job for the Indians tonight.
Minute 46 to play here, quarter number three. Good guys on top. Close one for a while, a little separation now.
Had a couple of turnovers to make it interesting, but hopefully Marquise can bounce back and earn the trust of the coaches. You know, he has had the fumble bug, and it's just something you have to deal with.
Trips left, single receiver right for Saunders. Second and 10. Got his man, found the crease. He's got about 6 yards across the 40-41. He took it away. How about this? Pickett's going to take this one to the house. Happened so fast. Pickett just stripped the ball from him and took it in.
Gandy caught the ball. And he had Kalen Lovett on his backside. Pickett came up from the safety spot and kind of stood him up. A backer came from the inside, and Pickett just ripped it before his forward progress had been stopped. It goes 35 yards for a defensive touchdown.
Special teams kind of getting everything together. They weren't ready for that one. Richie Grant's out there. Everybody's buckling their chin straps.
Yeah.
30-7. Mendoza with the attempt. Snap is good. Placement's up. Kick is up, and it is good. Well, Chris Pickett, I call him the Wicket Pickett. We're going to call him the Rip It Pickett. Ripped it away, took it in 31 yards.
Chris was, he's always making big plays on defense, whether it's a big hit, a nice tackle, an interception, what he became known for last year, which I think he had 10 in the big season, 13-game season they had last year, 14 games they played. Anyhow, great job with the strip. Strip and score.
Minute 27 left here in the third quarter. We'll keep it right here. And Navarre opening it up across town against the Vikes 35-7. Niceville in a tough one with Tate 21-13. Baker maintains 12-3 lead over Rocky Bayou, and Crestview up 45-21 over Pace. I pick Crestview in the Daily News panel of pick experts, and you thought I had just picked the upset of the century. These guys have more talent getting off the bus than anybody around here.
Yeah, they do.
Just a matter of time. They are loaded up there. Mendoza, see if he can kick another one out of the end zone, approaches it. It's going to go deep, and yes, he does. A little bit of a wind at his back, a little bit of a breeze, not a ton, but Jose does it again into the end zone, get to give the Marlins a long river to swim upstream against.
Third one of the night. They'll start at the 20. They haven't had great field position. 20, their own 1, 20, their own 12, own 11, own 20. Now they'll be at the own 7, own 20 again.
Again, special thanks to Okaloosa Gas for providing the bandwidth for the stream tonight. I tell your kids in life, nothing is free. If somebody says it's free, it's not true.
Somebody's paying.
Yeah, somebody's paying for it, and our good friends at Okaloosa Gas, they do a great job of that. Out of the spread. Twins to either side. He'll send a man in motion. They're going to look. Nope. Quarterback draw right up the middle. Saunders spins and caroms off a man. Good for an 11-yard gain and a first down.
Colby Dorsey and Pickett. That was a collision. And he was going straight north. Wasn't going to cut, slow down, or anything. And they banged in first down for the Marlins.
Clock running, approaching a minute. Dorsey will come out. Indians on top, 31-7. in a blink of an eye, it went from 14-7 to 31-7 as sacked by the Indians' Kyle Blanchard.
Yep, sophomore, 5'10", 210, came busting through on that left side. Lined up in that A/B gap.
Coach Pullum handles those D linemen. Coach Burnage, the linebackers. Coach Petrie, the D coordinator. Second down, 12 for the Marlins as the quarter's winding down. Saunders over the middle. Complete it midfield, right at the Christmas tree. We call it the Christmas tree. Looks like it's an arrow turned sideways.
Gilcrease caught that. He had to catch that one or they're going to knock him down. He planted that one between the 2 and 1. Saunders did, and it was tight coverage, but he fit it right in there.
20.9 seconds to play here in the third quarter. Out of the spread. Saunders looking left, firing right. He's got his man on a post. Complete inside the 30, 20. This one's going to go to the house.
Pickett got
touchdown, Alex Woolsey.
Lackadaisical there, and that kid's got some speed. He broke two tackles after the catch, and off he went.
31-13 as time expires. They'll kick the extra point. Or maybe they won't. Yes, they will.
Quick strike,
Guzman. Good snap, placement's up, and it's good. And just like that, it's 31-14, and that's going to do it for three quarters of play. We will be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on Emerald Coast TV.
Kirby Simpson State Farm is proud to support Choctaw's Touchdown Club and students for a field goal kicking contest. Please direct your attention to the South Indian football field.
Three quarters in the books, 31-14 at a treat during between quarters. Courtney Simpson, State Farm, sponsored a kicking contest. The young lady, if she knocked it through, got a $250 scholarship. If she missed it, the touchdown club got $250. And the good neighbor agent, Courtney Simpson, has coughed up $250 to the touchdown club. Kickoff taken at the 2. Got some jets across the 20, 40, one man to beat. A juke and a go. Here we go. Richie Grant all the way. Touchdown, Indians. No flags on the field. Wow. 99-yard touchdown run. Kickoff return by Richie Grant.
Unbelievable, explosive. Got three Hall of Famers in the car that were cheering for that one. Maddox, Carson, and Zoe love that one. Thanks, Richie Grant. Good night, kids.
37-14, just like that.
99 yards.
17 seconds off the clock. And Richie Grant's got to compose himself to hold this extra point.
Yeah, he's breathing heavily, like me walking up
high snap,
steps.
Brought down, kick is up, and it is good.
Oh, flag.
Well, flag came in late. Let's see.
Answered their five-play, 80-yard drive with a 99-yard kickoff return.
They'll sort this one out. Let's see. Procedure on the Indians, so it's going to be a do-over.
Nice bit of running by Richie Grant. Had to beat the kicker. Gave him the old stutter, slow down, fake in, and then turn the jets on to get up the sideline. I'll tell you what, though. Their little guy almost caught him. Nick Guzman obviously played soccer because he was running down the sideline chasing Richie.
So Mendoza, who's... we used to say someone would have to ice his leg down. He may have to do that tonight. He's doing it all, having to kick this one over. So it'll be from the 15, so it'll be the 25-yard extra point attempt. Hunter Merrill, good. Oh, and Richie Grant dropped the snap and picks it up, and down he goes.
Get down.
So 37-14, your score. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Big Green Radio Network and watching on Emerald Coast TV. That drive for touchdown was not a drive. It was a special teams 99-yard touchdown return. Brought to you by Scooter Brothers. Scooter Brothers, we fix stuff right here on Racetrack Road.
Talking at halftime about the cleaning job that was performed in the press box. Artwork hung. Got a microwave, I think. We need a mini fridge.
There's one down the hallway. Things just tend to disappear from it, though, I'm told.
We will have to lock this place down if we do put a mini fridge in.
Well, we started a couple of years ago with the microwave, and you brought the bar stools, which are literally so we could see over the ledge here. It's worked out to be our little home away from home. You know, I guess if it worst came to worst, you could live up here. There's a bathroom, everything but a shower.
Go to the field house for that.
Wow, we've woken up the dead. The lead Nissan scoring update. Navarre 35-14 in the third quarter. Crestview 45-21 in the fourth quarter. Another one in the end zone.
I wonder why they're not backing up and fielding those. It's interesting. I guess they watched us on film do the sky kick last week.
Yeah.
But he's been blasting them.
One more, two more home games for the Indians. Tate will make their way in here from Cantonment or Gonzales on the 23rd, and then Fort Walton Beach the night before Halloween. With Arnold, the Marlins brought their band in full costume. No traveling costumes for them. They're decked out.
Nah, they come.
They put on a show.
They do it like you should. Come and play, root the team on.
Out of the spread once again. Down goes Saunders. Still Niceville 21, Tate 13 in the third quarter. Lee Nissan scoring update. Not sure if that's from the ScoreStream app or if he's tuning in to Artie Goodman.
The new Fish Radio.
Almost a minute gone here in the fourth quarter. It was 14-7 for seemed like ever. And then the Indians opened it up 31-7. And then it's been a score fest by both teams. Run off left tackle. 3 yards.
Yeah, 14-0 at half. They've scored 14 as we just start the fourth quarter. The Indians put up 23.
Back to some correct math, the Indians are averaging 30 points a game, giving up 28. Interesting to hear Coach Thomas with his breakdown of the line play on both sides of the ball next week when we get to chat. Third down, four to go. Saunders looking. Now he's going to be flushed to his right. He's got some room. We're going to close on him. He's going to throw it. It's complete. Coach Thomas is saying out of bounds, and right in front of him, the referee is saying, nope, he's in.
Where is that kid? Did he ever get up?
Chains will move first and 10, Fish.
In the early 70s, Milton was winning state championships in 74. Then they won, Tate won a state championship. Carl Madison, Crazy Carl, was the head coach in 1980. But it has been a run. Pine Forest, is they won in 1987 and 1988. Niceville won in 88. Of course, we have our lone state championship in 1990. But in 84 and 85, Escambia won state championships. Woodham, in a higher classification, won in 84 and was runner-up in 85. And Rutherford won one in 99, or was runner-up in 99. Fort Walton Beach
won a state championship in 95. They're second.
Marcus Altson, yeah, they won.
Yeah.
They won two in 4 years.
91, they won their first one with Werfel. Pine Forest won another state championship in 2000. They were, in 79, Pine Forest was a runner-up while Milton won the state championship in the 3A classification. So,
you look at the number of athletes that came out. I remember Jerry Sansom telling me he was an assistant for Fort Walton during those Werfel years, Werfel, E.G. Green, and all those guys. And there was something like 30-some players over a three-year period that signed scholarships to play college football at all levels. Saunders on his horse, retreats, throws incomplete.
And I tell you, Choctaw had the most athletes in this 83-84. George Bethune, Willie Bryant, Todd Gatlin.
Big George.
Numerous players. They decided to change coaches and set the program back a decade.
Yeah. Second down, 10 to go. Indians on top, 37-14. Second and 10 here in the fourth quarter. 9:45 to play. Complete and a hard tackle.
Miles Betts.
Miles Betts
brings the wood.
Miles Betts, 5'8", 155. And he's every bit of just rock solid.
He's played a great ball game tonight. He's prepared well this week. He's kind of in the zone.
He reminds me back in the day of Demetrius Warmble. Not big, but boy, he would just knock you out. And
Demetrius had a different, he would run it up in there, and he was fearless.
Demetrius laid Joe McKnight out on this field, later of Southern California and the New York Jets. Timeout. The Arnold Marlins.
Third and four. They're going to think about it.
We'll keep it right here. Again, the season technically half over after tonight. We'll throw a bye week in there for us, but in six more weeks, the regular season will be history. Again, next week we're at Crestview. Pregame is at 6:40. Kickoff is at 7. Tune us in on WPSM or Panhandle EZStream.com or WPSM.com. Scotty Griffith, our producer, back at the station just working his magic. I'm not sure how many years this has been with him, but it's been like a marriage. It gets better with time, you know?
He makes it easy on our end. We don't have to worry about getting in and out of commercials or if we're on air or not on air. He's magic, like you said.
He knows he can finish the sentence before I say it, and I can tell him. I can tell when he wants a legal ID before it goes the other way. You got to invite him in for dinner one night. Get an assistant to run the board. And we'd never have a break.
Could do the old Hardy show.
All right, trips left, third down and four. Single receiver to the right for Saunders. First down is needed by them. Saunders is going to run the option. He pushes forward. Doesn't get it. Lucky held onto the ball.
Lost, bringing up fourth and about four.
Fourth down, 3 yards to go.
Fourth down and three. It's go time for the Marlins.
We've got our scoreboard working with what yard line it's on, down, distance.
We're one of the few that does that. It takes two to run the clock and two to work in harmony because you have your official timekeeper, then you have your school volunteer that does the down, distance, and yard line. Fourth down option. And we blow this one up. We do. It's going to be another turnover on downs. This one again for the Marlins. That's either their third or fourth TOD tonight.
Third.
So we'll see if Coach Thomas keeps Farrelly in, and he does. Jake Farrelly will stay in.
7 minutes, 48 seconds left in the contest, and Indians cruising.
Zach Childers thought he was in. He turned around and went, oh, man, I got to come out. another Marlin down on the far side.
They got him. He rolled over. It was a gang tackle over there.
That's John Doe, number 28.
Jimmy Hare.
Yeah. Watching live, you'll already know this, 9:23 Central Time here at Joe Etheredge Stadium. I think the Indian faithful hanging around. Some of them are filing out, beat the traffic. Marquise Kane back at tailback. Play action to Kane, fairly looking to go for a home run. He's going to have to eat it. Jake scrambles his way. Ball's loose, and do the Marlins have it?
No, clock's running. We have recovered it. Coach gives a signal.
Second down. Call it 11. From the Marlin 45-yard line here in the fourth quarter. Clock's running away, 37-14.
Play clock hasn't started. I don't know, has the thing been running? Yep, got 25 seconds to just.
Toss sweep, Kane left side, carries it in his right hand, down he goes. Went down quickly.
I'll tell you what, Arnold has not given up at all.
Nope.
Still running to the football. Dalton Likens came up and delivered a big blow. Good form tackle by the Marlin linebacker.
Isaac Smith checks in. Chris Pickett will check in. So they'll split wide right and wide left as Richie Grant and Bedell Merrill. Third and 12. Fairly. Here comes the blitz by the linebackers. Everything stops. Hold everything.
Coach is yelling at somebody.
Not happy, so it's going to bring a 5-yard penalty against the Indians and make it third down and 17 yards to go.
I think he was mad at Jake for not letting him get set, or he's mad at somebody. He's rightly so.
Place the ball right at the base of the arrowhead.
Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Now that you said that, that's all I see. Yeah. I used to see an arrow. Now all I see is a tree.
We'll need some lights and some ornaments. Fairly looking, fires it. Incomplete, almost. Caught there by Donovan Williams, intercepted by Donovan Williams.
Coach not happy. One of those things where they didn't use any of the clock, didn't execute.
6:01 to play here in the fourth as we approach hydration time. Jake will do the honors. Opening couple games, Jake punted. He really did a great job.
We'll do it on the change of possession. I got a good story about Coach Thomas.
Low snap, fairly quick punt. Nice kick, high kick. Arnold they'll run away from it. It'll bounce inside the 20 and we'll down it at the 16-yard line.
We're going to have to punt that again. We were moving.
Yeah. The up man was doing a tested Texas two-step. Illegal motion against the Indians, and like I said, this will come right back.
So Coach had they get pregame meal and have a speaker that comes and talks to them when they're finished eating, and it's different people. You've talked to them.
I haven't yet.
Not yet?
Not yet.
I was fortunate enough to talk to them, and today my dad did with some of the guys from the 1990 team that were in town. And well, pick it up after this punt.
Jake Fairley again. Only about 12 yards from the snap. Hunter Merrill, good snap. Two-step boot. And once again, they run away from it. This one's going to do even better. Inside the 10-yard line, we'll down it at about the 8-yard line.
Good job.
It should be time for hydration. Time to finish the story.
5:34. So I think there was 6 or 7 guys that played on the 90 team and my dad, and they all show up talking to the team and delivering a message. And coach, after their finish, giving the speech, talking to them, coach says, "You guys look like you need something to wear to the game." And guy had a box of the Adidas golf shirts, the black shirts we wear on the road games.
Coach Thomas gave him some shirts.
Started handing them out. he gave one to my dad. And like I said, seven or eight of the guys, they all had them on tonight.
So that's great.
Spread the love. They were proud. They were decked out in their black, talking about, "I wish we would have had black jerseys or black helmets when we played."
Time out for our water break right now. 37-14 Indians on top. This water break sponsored by Fantastic Sam's. Fantastic Sam's, a proud sponsor of the Choctawhatchee Touchdown Club. Yeah, I bet those guys were beaming. Probably ripped their shirts off and threw those on as quick as they could get them on.
They did. They all had them on pregame, and we're proud to sport the black polo.
So the Marlins backed up inside their 10-8, 5 minutes, 34 seconds. Indians comfortably out front. As soon as we say that, somebody scores. Saunders again, he's committed to West Virginia, the quarterback. Cody Saunders, he's on his horse now. He's in the end zone, gonna have to throw this one away. Lobs it up, no one there. Into the Choctaw cheerleaders, almost took one of them out.
Hit their water machine.
And there it comes. Intentional grounding, two flags are coming in. And it's a safety because it was done in the end zone.
Yeah, I guess they said there was no receiver in the area, but he threw it 30 yards downfield.
Yeah.
It hit the water bucket on the 30 out of bounds.
Before it hit the cheerleader. On the leg.
And but I guess the receiver, they're saying, wasn't close enough. Of course he's throwing it away so he avoids the sack, but is the receiver close enough? Nope. Safety.
Wow, the fun continues, but it's good for the good guys in the green shirts and the black pants. 39-14. The Indians opening it up, beating the spread, and doing whatever you want to say. Yeah, getting a nice little, sending a message up State Road 85 to Crestview to let them know that we're getting ready for next week.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. That's going to be a battle, as you say, whether it's chemistry or just not catching breaks or not playing together. They're talented up there. They just haven't been able to win a lot of games the last few years, but put together an impressive win last week and have another one going this week. Although last week, was that the Sisters of the Poor?
That was the International School of Broward Pediatric Ward, I believe.
The International House of Pancakes. But it got them all on the winning ways.
That was their second win of the year in the Knights. A big win for Crestview against Pace. Coach Mickey Lindsay, the head coach at Pace, he said his son's the head coach at Tate, right?
Yeah. They play each other this year.
This will be a two-step kickoff, probably a sky kick or a squib. By Guzman. No, he boots this one high left. Taken by Kalen Lovett. Lovett's got a head of steam. He's across midfield. Kalen Lovett gets tripped up at the 34-yard line and falls down at the 31.
He was cruising. Got caught from behind, but a great job returning that one.
Fairly stays in at quarterback. We were thinking we might see the lefty.
Jawan
Taylor.
Not
yet.
You think you could get him a couple of reps just to have the emergency quarterback, because he's listed as a wide receiver. He's a senior. He's 6'3", 190. Lefty.
Let him snap it. Kane's your tailback. Turner's your up back.
I guess Richie would be the next QB if they really got into a bind.
Marquise Kane down, 1 yard gain. As the Indians open it up 39-14. 4 minutes, 45 seconds and counting. Coach Thomas, last time, they didn't run the clock like he was hoping. give Marquise two on the play. Second down and eight from the 30. Option. Nope. Turner's going to keep it on the quick hitter on the counter option. Mike may have gotten a yard.
I haven't seen that play yet. That might be the first time they've run that tonight. Getting a little chippy, chippy talky.
Mike's dad, the former player here, right?
Yep, he graduated in 89. His dad was a defensive lineman. Mean.
All right, Childers back in at tail. Twins right. Tight end to the left side is Nash. Play action. Oh, it's going to be the naked bootleg. Inside the 25, taken down at the 21. That's good. It should be good for an Indian first down. Gutsy call this late in the game.
Yeah. The naked bootleg with the quarterback up by 25.
Childers will stay in, and he'll line up at fullback. Kane's at tailback. 3.5 to play. Clock's running from the 20. Of the Marlins. Kane. Marquise Kane inside the 10. Marquise Kane taking down at the 6.
Hold on to the tight. We're going to call him hold on tight. Kane.
Nothing fancy there. Just reverse pivot by the quarterback. Right off left guard. So first and goal from the 6 with 3 minutes 13 seconds and ticking in this game. Out of the eye. Kane, right side, Marquise Kane, touchdown, Indians. 45-14.
What's the mercy rule?
That's we got a penalty. As they sort it out, let's see. Indians are walking backwards.
Is it a touchdown?
Unsportsmanlike conduct after the touchdown, I assume. So they'll enforce it on the kickoff. Make you scratch my head.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Indians.
No, they won't. They'll back us up now.
Penalty is being assessed on the conversion.
Which will spot it at the 18-yard line. So a 35-yard field goal attempt, extra point attempt. And we'll see if Mendoza can do like he did against Pine Forest with ice water in his veins. The snap is good, the placement's good, the kick is up, and it is wide left.
That would have been a long one.
45-14. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're listening to Big Green Radio Network. Well, the Indians tack some more on. Marquise Kane goes in from 6 yards out. This touchdown drive brought to you by Cameron Simpson, attorney at law. Indians about ready to just take this one to the house, call it a night. Luckily, been no injuries on the Indian side.
It's a minute, 27 seconds, 5 plays, 32 yards. Capped off by the...
Unfortunately for the Indians last week, Ian Terrio broke a bone, and he is out for the year. Last of the Terrio brothers. And down goes the return man at the 16-yard line. Thompson.
Did he have a broken bone? His foot.
Played on it the rest of the game, too.
Yowie.
2 minutes, 44 seconds to go in this contest. Indians will get off the 500 mark, go to 3-2 before we head to Crestview next week. And then a week to regroup before it's over to Niceville.
Defense has done a great job tonight. Playing sound fundamental defense. kicking game came around a little bit. Special teams was great in the return game.
Pass complete out in the right flat. Out route up to the 28-yard line. Shane should move first and 10, 2 minutes, 11 seconds to play. And with a chorus of fight on by the Style Marchers and everybody having fun, this one will be in the books in just a few minutes. Effect the read option, slant over the middle, good across the 40 to the 42. And we have a penalty flag back at the 22-yard line.
Generally in the holding area. Only bad thing about that one is it
just lengthens the game.
Stops the clock.
Last score, Baker over Rocky Bayou, 20-14 was the last score. Navarre, 55-14 over Fort Walton.
First down, Marlins.
Call the dogs off.
Crestview, a final over Pace, 45-28. And just yesterday, Navarre over Milton, 3-1 in varsity volleyball. Indians yesterday dropped one of their crosstown rivals, a straight setter against the Vikings. The Indians ranked 1 in the state.
Wow.
Wake up call before they got to go to Crestview next week and then the district tournament coming up. And hand off to Thompson going right. Down he goes in the backfield.
Good job by Jean Bernay.
Broadwater in on the tackle along with Bernay. Second and 10. Minute 20 to play. Second down. Three-step drop by Saunders. Now he's going to run it up the middle. He gets about 5, maybe 6 across the 44 to the 45.
He's a competitor. Saunders hasn't quit for a minute in this game. Good athlete. Good. It's been fun watching him play tonight.
Third down. As we're under a minute to play. Saunders will keep it. Gets his first down across the 30 to the 29-yard line. And we will vacate the premises, lock up the booth, unplug the microwave until we come back on October 23rd. It's going to be a while.
That is a long run before we venture back to the booth.
Yeah. Back-to-back games there at home, the 23rd and the 30th against Tate and Fort Walton. And then on the road, our last game of the year, which has been a long time since we've been on the road for the final game against Mosley. Complete at the 15-yard line, taken down at the 10. With 12 seconds, clock has stopped with 11 and a half seconds. The Marlins want to get one in for pride's sake.
Yep.
They trail it 45-14, 11 seconds. Trips left. Lob it over.
Oh, what a catch.
Incomplete. And laundry down at the 9-yard line with 2.4 seconds.
That was a great effort by the Marlin Paul Patterson. 6'1", 178-pound senior. Went up high to get it with one hand. Almost came down with it.
Well, congrats to the Indians all the way around. We've got a defensive holding on the Indians, but this one, for all intents and purposes, is in the book.
2.4 seconds.
Marlins are going to take a timeout to try to dial up one trick play. Like any playing in the streets, you're going to draw one up in the dirt.
You go here, you go there.
Go along on two. Place was rocking last night as the undefeated Pryor Pirates had their first loss of the season against the undefeated bunch from Shoal River. Congrats to Coach Rex Bowman and Pryor for what he's done over there this year. They got a good team.
Yeah, they're scrappy, good athletes, and I wish I could have made it over to watch that. I had a CEU class.
All right, last play of the game, 2 seconds. Marlins are battling pride right now. Trips left, single receiver right. Saunders is your QB. He may tuck it and run. Nope, he's going to lob this one incomplete. That's it. We think it would ever end, but it finally did. The Indians get on a roll and keep on going. 45-14. Again, next week, we head to Crestview. Pregame is at 6:40. Kickoff is at 7. We'll be in that stadium somewhere. For Scotty Griffith and Lionel Fayard, this is Tom Brassell saying good night, everybody.